Hi guys, this is Mr. Fixer. Today I will show you how to fix the application was unable to start correctly error. This error can occur in any game or application. In order to solve this error for sure, it is necessary to know the cause of the problem. But before moving on to the definitive solution, check if the issue is resolved by following a few check, install and repair steps that might work for you. First, check for Windows updates. Go to Windows Update by typing Update in the Start menu. Click Check for Updates, and if there is a new update, wait for it to download and install. Then go to the Start menu again and type CMD. Right-click Command Prompt and click Run as an administrator. Copy and paste the commands in order and press Enter. You can find the commands in the description. Wait for the PC to be scanned and repaired if there is a problem. There was a problem with my PC too. It says it fixed the problem and show the location of the report file. Then download the recommended version of Net Framework from Microsoft's site if you don't have it installed. Run setup and install. I already have it installed. If you don't have it installed, click continue. Again, go to Start menu and open Control Panel. Select Programs and Features and click Turn Windows Features On or Off. Tick all the files starting with .NET Framework and click OK. If it is unchecked, it will do a short install the first time you tick it. Next, download Visual C++ 2015 to 2022 package from Microsoft's site. Even if your system is 64-bit, download both x64 and x86 versions. Run and install the setups. If it's already installed, click Repair. After these steps, you can reach the corrupted or missing files and solve your problem without any further effort. But if you still get the same error, it means that probably there is a 32-bit DLL file in the 64-bit folder or a 64-bit DLL file in the 32-bit folder of your Windows. Before solving, I will show what caused the error. Do not follow the steps I will show until the solution part. I show these parts only to explain why the error occurs. As an example, let's open the Epic Games Launcher, the app that many people are having this problem with. Launcher is running. There doesn't seem to be an error for me. Now let's replace one of the DLL files required for Launcher to work. I open the Windows folder from the drive where Windows is installed, which is C drive for me. Open the System32 folder. I find the Zinput13 DLL files and back them up to the desktop just in case. Then I delete the file from the System32 folder. Then I copy the same DLL in the 64-bit folder. And open the System32 folder and paste the 64-bit DLL there. Now let's try running the Epic Games Launcher. And we got the application was unable to start correctly error. So how do you fix this error? First of all, you need to find out which DLL file you are getting the error from. For this, download Microsoft's Process Monitor application and follow the steps I will show next to solve your own error. You can find the link in the description, create a folder, and move the RAR file to the folder. Right-click and extract the files. For you, it will show as extract here. Then run procmon. First, click File and select Capture Events Disable to turn off the reporting process. Then click Clear to delete all reports. Click on Filter and select Process Name. Type the name of the .exe file of the application you see in the error message and click Add. Then click Apply and OK. Now click File again and click Capture Events to start the reporting process. Run the application you're getting the error on, and the application's report is listed. Close Capture Events again. Let's try to find the faulty DLL file by examining the name not found in the results section. To do this, right-click any name not found and select Highlight. Expand the path section a bit and examine the DLL files in the colored lines. Every DLL file you see does not mean it is corrupt. Notice the DLL file you've seen here more than a few times. For me, it's the Zenput 1.3 DLL. There are also different DLL files, but we can assume that the error is due to Zenput 1.3 as there are too many. So how do we find this file in the Windows folder? When you examine the colored lines, you can see the different locations of the file in the path section. We need to look for files located in System 32 or SysWow 64. However, you may still not see it clearly in the path section. For this, right-click on the DLL file that we assume is corrupt and select Properties. Open the Process section. Next to Architecture, it says 64-bit. The reason you got the error was that the 64-bit file was in the 32-bit folder, or the 32-bit file was in the 64-bit folder. Here, since we see that the architecture of the corrupt file is 64-bit, we understand that the location of this file is the System 32 folder. We need to go to the drive where Windows is installed. Then open the Windows folder. Find and open the System 32 folder. Then find the DLL file that you determined to be faulty and delete it. Now we need the correct version of the DLL that we deleted. Let's see which package is needed for me. You can find which DLL file is in which package in the description section of the video. Open the search box with Ctrl F and type the DLL name and click Find Next. I saw that the DLL file I need to download is in the DirectX End User Runtimes package. Click the link and download the package. This is the offline installation package of DirectX. So first, I extract the files to a folder I created on the desktop. Then I run DX setup and install it. This installation process does not corrupt other files on your PC and completes the missing ones. I actually backed up the correct DLL to the desktop, but I'm fixing the issue with setup so you can see if it works. The installation is finished. Let's check if the correct version of the DLL file that we deleted in System 32 is loaded. DLL file is loaded. Now let's try to open Epic Games Launcher again. And as you can see, if you delete the wrongly copied DLL file and install the package with the correct file, your problem will be solved as well. But do not search and download these DLL files on other sites. Or do not copy it to the folder of the application where you got the error, as suggested by some sources. Even if these solutions work for the program you're getting the error for, you may still get the same error in different programs or games in the future. The most effective and safe way is to get the missing files by installing the necessary Microsoft packages. You can find the relevant Microsoft links in the description section. For Visual C++, you can find the package between 2015 and 2022 by scrolling down. Also, even if your system is 64-bit, download both x64 and x86 versions of whatever package you want to download. If the package you downloaded is already installed, select the Repair option. You can also access older packages from the same page by scrolling down. That's all. Don't forget to like if this video helped you. If the issue is still not be fixed or have another question, let me know in the comments section below. Also, you can support me by subscribing to the MrFixer. Don't forget to all errors must be fixed. See you in the next video.